Hello. How are you all? Hope everyone is doing great. Your first session, your first online session is on the chapter tenses. I'm going to talk to you about tenses. Does anyone know what tenses mean? What do you know about tenses? What is tenses? When we talk about tenses, we're talking about time. Tenses means time. In lower grades, we have learned verbs and we've learned simple present tense. We have learned present time and past time and the past participles. Today we're going to learn a bit more detail about verb tenses. And you know, verb is an action word. And when we're talking about tenses, we are going to talk about when the action was done. Of course, the action, what is called events, they can be done in the past, they can be done now, and they can be done in the future. Past is what is already finished, and now is what is happening at the present time, and what will happen is what is a future time. Okay, we have three forms: present, past, and future. The tense of a verb tells when an action happens. Present time means now, past time is already what has happened, and future is what will happen. Now let me give you some examples. The simple present tense is used for an action which always or usually happen. The sun rises in the east. The sun rises in the east today. The sun rises in the east tomorrow. The sun yesterday also it rose in the east. There is no change to that. It always rises in the east. So this is a nature's law. So something that happens every day and which cannot be changed, it is always in simple present tense. Another example is water boils at 100 degree. Water will not boil at 99 degree. That's a scientific truth. So scientific truth, universal truth, all this happens. When all this happens, it takes the present tense form. Now look at the next one, the general statements or fact, like she likes strawberries. She likes strawberries today. She likes strawberries yesterday. She will like strawberries tomorrow as well. Something that is of her habit. She drinks milk in the morning. Every day she drinks milk in the morning. So that's a habit. All right. She goes to school by car. So daily happening, universal truth, habits, all these normally take the form of simple present tense. Some other examples where we use simple present tense. We use simple present tense for adverbs. Some adverbs like always, often, usually, sometimes, rarely, never, every day. I always come to school by car. I do not come here very often. I come here very often. I usually sit here. I usually go to bed early. I usually eat my breakfast at 7 o'clock. Sometimes I go to the party. I will not say sometimes I went to the party. Sometimes I go to the party. Or you cannot say sometimes I will go to the party. I can say sometimes I will go to the party tomorrow. Something which happens on daily basis, regularly, or it's my habit, it's always in simple present tense. Okay, these are some other examples. She rarely cooks, he's never late for class, they sleep early every day. All right, so these are some places that I must use simple present tense. Now I have some form of simple present tense, the be form. I have it in the singular as well as the plural and short form and the long form. Normally pronouns like I, only I takes up am. I, when you see the word I, it is am. When you see the word pronoun you, though you is singular, it always takes the plural form of the verb. It is considered as a plural pronoun. So you will not say you is coming or you is going. You are coming. You are going. You are playing. Okay. He, she, it takes it form. The present form of be is. Okay. And for the plural, it is are. All right. Now look here, something more, something shorter. Some simple present tense is used to express the idea that an action is repeated or usual. So for a repeated action, which is a habit or a usual habit or a usual action, we use simple present tense. The action can be a habit, a hobby, a daily event, a scheduled event, like the bell rings at 7 o'clock. It rings every day at 7 o'clock. Or something that often happens, or something that rarely happens. All right. This is a simple fill in the blanks, which I want to show you as an example. Use the simple present form of verb in the box. Do, go, like, listen, play. I like collecting things. Paul listens. Okay. I have added the S to the verb listens here because Paul is he. Singular verb, singular subject. Nicola goes shopping on Saturdays. My brother does martial arts. My friend and I play. See, I is singular, but it takes the form, the verb form is plural. The verb form is plural. See, for listen is now a verb and it is a plural form. When I add S to listen, it becomes listens. So if I have a singular subject, I must have a singular verb. That is Paul listens. Understood? It is again simple form. Simple form is the root form.